All right, Clayton, thanks so much. A yacht club is too offensive. That's at least what the student senate at Pitzer College says. One student senator saying the majority of senators found the name yacht club to have a particularly offensive association with yacht clubs and a recreation known for being exclusive. Well, Stephen Glick is a student at neighboring Pomona College and the publisher of the Claremont Independent that first reported on this, and he joins me now. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks so much for having me. It's great to be here.
So were you surprised? I mean, it doesn't seem like a yacht club would be too offensive, but apparently it's luxurious and classist, even though it costs $64,000 a year, we're told, to go to this school.
You know, to be honest, it's not too much of a surprise. I think the PC police have been going further and further every day with what they're deeming offensive. It's become increasingly trivial concerns for what should be censored or banned. We've had instances on campus with America-themed parties being deemed too offensive. We had a party called Mud Goes Mad at Harvey Mudd College that was deemed too offensive because the phrase going mad is offensive to students with mental health disabilities. So really, I think this is just continuing on in that trend. It's unfortunately not a surprise to see.
Yeah, the sirens of the PC police are certainly going on that campus, it seems like. But some existing student organizations that, you know, that are in place right now, the Smart Sex Society, well, some people would say that that's great and it's going to keep students healthy. Others would say, well, that's offensive to people who believe in waiting till marriage. How about the Tattoo Club? Some people would say that's really cool and that's great. And others would say, no, your body is a temple. That's offensive. Doesn't it seem like this student senate is kind of picking and choosing what they deem to be offensive?
Absolutely. It seems that there's a bit of a social justice mission in determining which clubs can be approved and which ones can't. The student senators are really, in some cases, overreaching what their role should be and going too far and sort of putting their own political bent on which organizations they allow on campus.
Well, here's what the school has to say. This is their statement. They say, Pitzer College respects the diverse views of our student body and believes that discussions and sometimes debate on opposing views are part of the educational experience. How do you respond, Stephen?
I would absolutely agree. And I think shutting down the conversation by telling a club that they shouldn't be allowed on campus does absolutely nothing to further that goal. I think the club said it was going to be open to any student, and any students who wanted to learn more about the club would have been welcome to stop by and hear what the club's founders and members had to say. I think anytime you're telling someone that they're not able to organize and express themselves in the way they want, you're absolutely not encouraging free expression and discussion.
Yeah, well, the other side is, you know, Yacht Club, it sounds like Biff and Buffy go and they have all, you know, they're drinking champagne with gold flecks in it or something. But then you could easily see the other side. I'm from the South. Why not call it the Redneck Yacht Club? Just change the name, drink out of some red Solo cups, and maybe it'll work out for you. Stephen Glick, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you so much.
Yacht Club, so offensive. 27.